Good morning, parents and pupils. This morning we'll be having English grammar and we'll be looking at the verb have and has. What we are looking at is the verb have and has. And what is a verb? A verb is an action word. Even though have and has come from the same word, there are slightly differences in the way they are used. How can we use have? Have is used with I, you, we, ye, and they. While has is used with he, she, and it. I, you, we, ye, they, he, she, and it. They are examples of pronouns. And what is a pronoun? A pronoun is a word we use instead of a noun. And what is a noun? A noun is a name of any person, animal, place, or thing. For example, Ade is a boy. Ade is a noun. Instead of me to say Ade is a boy, I will change my Ade to he. He is a boy. He there represents my pronoun. Now let's look at the meaning of have and has. The meaning of have and has is 1. To possess. 2. Own. 3. Hold for use. 4. Contain. It also means possession, to possess, to show ownership of a thing. For example, this is my bag. It shows I am the owner of that bag. It does not belong to you. It shows ownership. It shows possession. Now let's look at examples of how we can use have or has. He dashed three books. He dashed three books. It would be he has three books. Number 2, the pupils have 4 bags. Pupils there is a noun, is not a pronoun. I've taught you in the class before. 1 represents singular. When something is more than 1, it represents plural. Now, pupils represent plural. That means they are more than 1. So, the pupils have 4 legs. Pupils there, you will change it to they. That will be the pupils have 4 bags. And this is our classwork. You are to fill in the gap with either have or has. Number 1, I dash a white cap. It's either you fill it with have or has. Number 2, they dash 5 toys. It's either you fill it with have or has. Number 3, she has dash gentle voice. Is either you fill it with have or has. Number 4, he dash many houses. Number 5, it dash a long tail. Thank you and God bless you. Submit to me privately.